Martha Dick is a Shoshone Indian living on the Duck Valley Reservation in northern Nevada. She speaks with quiet dignity about her family's heritage and skills, including the construction and use of cradle boards, a practice passed down in her family for many generations. Martha and her son Richard recently made a cradle board, which they call a baby basket, for Richard's son Badaguchi. They used willow to weave the frame, but Martha points out that her family, which is Shoshone, has certain traditional preferences which differ from those of Richard's wife's family, which is Paiute.
The Paiutes from Nixon and Reno area, their basket is different. They make the frame, and the willows that they put inside here, they run it up and down, and where we run it across, and then I put denim, a heavy denim, along the side here where the willows won't stick out or come loose, or, you know, when it's being used. I use nails to tack them down so it'll be sturdy. Otherwise, it'll fall apart.
An infant is wrapped securely inside a baby basket, allowing very little movement. Although this is a generations-old practice, is it good for the child? And does the baby basket fill a real need in today's world? Martha's son Richard says yes.
I think it does, because, you know, when the kid gets fussy and he's, you know, they get all hyped up, it soothes them down, you know. It just, you wrap them up and it's nice and cozy. Just like a lot of, they write books about babies and stuff, and they say to swaddle them in a cloth and then put them in, you know, a nice dark room or something, not a real dark room, but, you know, when it cools them off, just calms them down.
And Martha adds,
to get to rest, and where you are, especially when you go someplace, you carry a baby and it sleeps on your lap, or it's really good. In the wintertime, they're warm, and then in summertime, I know some people just lace the baby up, and just not too tight, but just let it without any, you know, heavy blankets or whatever. When you go shopping, I know we put him in a shopping cart and wheel him all over the place.
Is no certain age when a baby outgrows its basket?
Well, it depends. I think it's mostly that the baby outgrows the cradle board themselves. Automatically just don't want the cradle board anymore. Or else, if the cradle board falls apart, then they say, well, he's too big, can not make another one.
Baby baskets are a material, physical expression of both Paiute and Shoshone culture, but they are also symbolic and play an important role for many non-material beliefs and traditions. Some Paiute families, such as Richard's in-laws, for example, wrap the baby's umbilical cord in a small, decorated buckskin pouch and attach it to the basket's sunscreen.
They comes off of the baby. They put it in a little buckskin pouch and they bead around it. When he gets, I don't know how old, I'm not sure how old he'll be, probably a year or whatever, then his dad will take this up and to the mountain someplace where there's, you know, where there's no roads or whatever, and then he'll just put it wherever nobody can find it, where it'll just, you know, be part of the earth again.
And this will assure that the child will always have a home, a place on this earth that is his. But is it important to keep these old Paiute and Shoshone ways alive, to pass them on to the next generation?
I think it's important, because I know a lot of the kids, they should know something about their own people, and it gets away from you, but it has to stay with you like the old people. They were, it's almost an every evening thing with them.
The series Home Means Nevada presents Folklife from the Silver State and is produced by the Nevada State Council on the Arts. Folk Arts Coordinator Blanton Owen, in cooperation with KUNR Reno, KNPR Las Vegas, and KOLO Reno, with funding from the National Endowment for the Arts Folk Arts Program and the State of Nevada. This is Deb Spring.